Welcome back to a new part of Behind the Escape. Today I'm playing the Escape from the Witch map, and we'll just start. In this series I am showing you what is going on behind the scenes in the escape maps I make for Quena, and you can of course ask any questions if I have not explained everything well enough. So this is the first time I use custom designs, as you can see here. Those are actually just 3D models that are made to look like signs, but since they are 2D models, they have their own texture and I can put anything on them, including pictures. Here we have those pushable blocks that I use all the time. Then now there's something new again. I use advancements to give some extra information. I just retextured the toes texture that appears in the top right to look like that thing you just saw. So I just got a button here and then I will activate this. Those are just simply some ender crystals that are aimed at the sky. And now I'm in the swamp. In this swamp I can already see the witch hut over there, but to properly continue I need two players here, so that's why I am here two times. There is a pressure plate behind this pile of crates back there, and if I stand on it then I will unlock this, or will push this thing upwards. Because I can't swim in water, I need that. So I will do that, jump over here, and then we can see another pressure plate right here. If I step on this one, then again the same platform will be appear, but this allows me to get my second account to also go over here. He's over there, hello. And now I can also cross with my second account. And then there is, if I step on this pressure plate that I'm standing on right now, there's also a second platform. So anyway, if I step on this pressure plate, this platform also appears. And then there's another pressure plate over here that also makes that platform appear. So I stand on this pressure plate, the other player can cross, and then the other player stands on this pressure plate so that I can cross. And finally we reach the witch hut, which again has two pressure plates right here. So I need my other account again to step on it. And that will then open the door of the witch hut. And I can enter it now. So up here, there does not appear to be anything. Nothing to prove that, but I can open those drawers here. That's also quite simple. It works just like my big chest. The drawer is actually just a model on top of an armor stand, and the chest is retextured to be invisible. So there's an invisible chest here, and a armor stand with a model in the same position. Now I can take this pumpkin pie, and this will probably start the escape, because the witch doesn't like that I steal her cake. And now I need to escape from this room. Over here we have three armor stands inside jukeboxes that display their name over their head, and that's zero. And if I look around I can find some music discs here, one in this brewing stand, one at top of those crates, then another one right here. And if I put them into those jukeboxes, they each have their own unique number. I simply check for the tag of the jukebox which record it has in it, and then I and the data, the armor stand with a different name. Now we can see here that the code is 415, so I have the wrong numbers here. I want 1, but I don't want 2 and 3, so those are those two music discs actually wrong. There are two more. One of them is on this mountain. I press this button and it gets removed and will appear on another side of the mountain. Just do that 4 times and a chest will be cloned into here. And this one is number 4. That just leaves number 5, which is back here. just go through those rooms, and then in the nether room over here, there's a shulker box with the last music disc in it. Okay, apparently I'm still on fire, but now I can put the last music disc in there, and the staircase will pop up. It works similarly to the flying blocks that I've shown in previous episodes. It's an armor stand with a block on its head, and I changed the model of all blocks to a bigger size, because usually they are quite small if you put them on top of an armor stand. And I just teleport the armor stands upwards, and it looks like a staircase popping up. And then once they're in the right position, I kill the armor stand and replace it with the actual block. For this, I need to take the flower from back there, and then I can put it into this flower pot, and over there the door will open. And then I simply need to walk around the whole area again. I can't go this direction because there are crates. And now this ice spike comes into play because I need to use it as a platform, because once again there are crates here. And now I'm here. And now we're in this room. And there's a sign, if I click it, I will be transformed into a silverfish. I really kinda like this effect, because it does appear like I am quite small, but in reality I am not really small. Everything you can see is models. Every block here is actually 4 blocks. You can see that the coordinates change. So I changed the models of some blocks to 4 times the size of a normal block, placed them and filled the rest with barriers. This sign is just a scaled up version of the custom sign model I use. In the other room, the skull is on top of a baby zombie. Here it's on top of a wither skeleton, so that makes it a lot bigger. And yeah, basically that's it. This pressure plate is somewhat interesting, because it actually works and it also makes sound and everything. But I just detect there's just an armor stand here that places a block that either looks like a press or a not press pressure plate, depending if I'm on it or not. And it also places sound. Now I got the creeper transformation. I can also click the big sign, because I placed some invisible villagers there, and with that I can detect right-clicking. And now my creeper. Creepers can, well, if I'm a creeper, I can cause an explosion by sneaking. Just check for the sneak time score of the player, and if that is at least 1, then a explosion will be caused. There's also a cooldown, but that doesn't really matter. And if you press shift and cause the explosion while you are exactly this position somewhere, then it will simply break this wall with a fill command. And then the last shape is the bat. When you are a bat, you can fly by sneaking, and for that it just gives you the levitation effect. You might be able to see it for a short time. And again, I detected with the sneak time score, and as soon as I stop sneaking, I will fall down again because I don't have the effect anymore. And finally I can continue to the last room, which is this one. This one has a few puzzles for all of those themes here. In the desert one I simply need to press all the wooden buttons. There's not really much to it. There's just a counter on a scoreboard going on that sees how many buttons I've pressed, and every button removes itself after I clicked it. Then in the snow one I simply need to climb up the mountain, and then it's already there. Yeah, right here. It's just a chest and the ice essence. Then the next one is the plains one. Here we can see some dirt blocks that don't behave like you'd expect. Just again, dirt block on top of an armor stand, and then the model changed in a way that the block appears bigger. And if I press this button, all of this will disappear and I can get the nature essence. Then for this nether one, I only need to do the parkour. And I can get another essence. And finally there is the end one. It's probably the hardest. And in this one, every time you walk over a end portal frame, it will change between having an Eye of Ender in it or not. Just do an execute detect command if there is a end portal frame below the player, and change it to an end portal frame with Eye of Ender in it. Once I do this for all three of them, the Eye of Ender will appear in my Ender chest. If you didn't know, you can modify the contents of a player's Ender chest by using slash replace item. Now finally I have all 5 ingredients, and here it tells me to throw them into the cauldron. And if I do that, the cauldron will break and this wither will appear. And this wither is actually a model, which is why it can spin around in this weird way. And yeah, it's just a model on top of our armor stand again. And then once it dies automatically, it drops this potion, which gives me a variety of effects. And with that I can finally escape from the witch. If you still have any questions on how something worked, feel free to leave a comment and I will explain how that specific thing works. But anyway, that's it. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.